Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Blue Podcast with me, Josh, and Tom, the two chiefs of the Blue Podcast. We're doing a This is very, very rare, so do enjoy the show while you can. It is the Royal Blue Show, the first show in absolutely ages.
Probably talking a long time. Very long time.
But there's a cup semi-final approach against one of the clubs that Chelsea hit the most, so we have to talk about it. We didn't get any Spurs fans on because they're irrelevant. JK Spurs fans, you're all welcome. But for this, it is just the two Chelsea fans. So, Tom, how are you doing?
I'm all right, mate. It's weird to be on the other end of my my own channel. But, you know, being the guest is always fun. Pleasure to be on the Royal Blue Show, finally. Long time coming, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has been a long time coming, but I'm glad you're here anyway. So, obviously, Chelsea play Tottenham Hotspur at Stamford Bridge tomorrow at 7:45. The game's on Sky Sports. It is a two-legged game, but that's just the way it is. Before we get into this game, very, very quickly, I do want to quickly ask you about the Lukaku situation. Just rolls into the team news. Obviously, the reports have basically all came out. Basically, Thomas Tuchel has said that Lukaku's apologised behind closed doors. And it does sound like he is going to be back into the squad at some point. It could be tomorrow night, could be against Chesterfield, could be the week after, don't know. But he will likely be back. Do you agree that he should play in blue colours again, or is it more a fact that Chelsea don't really have a choice though at the same time, do they? Because they can't really offload him. So
I think it's a matter of we ain't got a choice, and also a player of that quality we can't just drop for a whole rest of the season, really. With all the games we've got, the lack of a striker we've got, also with Timo Werner out, and Havertz is still coming back from COVID. Yeah, I mean, I don't see him starting tomorrow or today. But I can see him back probably. I can see him in the squad, certainly, on the subs bench. I'd be surprised if he's not on the bench, at least. But it depends how the game goes, obviously. I think Spurs will put quite a strong side out, which is obviously not ideal for us, which then means you definitely have to have Lukaku in the squad, realistically. At the end of the day, Chelsea comes first, and yes, he's disrespected the club, disrespected Tuchel and the board, but winning is the most important thing, really, which is beating Spurs at home. We need to beat Spurs at home, and if he has to be played, it's kind of the better of two evils, if that makes sense.
Yes. I do agree. I think, you know, he's our world record signing. He's on 300k a week. We don't have another striker at the club, which comes down to the board's fault, realistically, for not having a backup striker. That comes down to the board's fault. For a situation like this has happened where it's caused issues. But I think Lukaku comes back. And the way I put it, if he comes out and apologises to the fans and he goes onto the pitch and, you know, runs for the Chelsea badge, plays for the club, scores a ton of goals and helps us, I think that's more. But if he goes onto the pitch and shows the fact that he doesn't care, then he can piss off, pretty much.
Thing that confuses me, right, is obviously this interview happened before he then got brought back on at halftime against Villa, played really well, got man of the match, and then got man of the match against who was before Liverpool? Mine's gone blank. Who did you play before Liverpool?
I think it was Aston Villa, wasn't it?
No, it wasn't Villa, because he came on half time for Villa. Who did we
I'm gonna have to check this out, because
I've been confused. But yeah, he got two man of the match performances in a row, and obviously that was after the interview, so I don't see him.
Brighton.
If you do check out the Blue Podcast, is it a one horse race? I have a little bit of a rant about the Brighton game, I can't see him not putting a shift in for Chelsea, because obviously even after that interview he was putting a shift in for Chelsea. Obviously we don't know, but I can be pretty hopeful, and I'm sure he'll, as he said in his interview, I'm a professional, I'm working hard, so fingers crossed.
No, I do completely agree with you. I think I think Lukaku will play. The interview clearly was at a bad time. He was injured. He wasn't being correct. Maybe it was just a bad frustration interview at the time, but as I said, the talking on the pitch were pretty much everything that we need to know about Romelu Lukaku's future at Chelsea. So on to the game off the matter. So that is obviously a game against the club that we hate the most, as Spurs.
The team are playing 3 times in 1 month, which is mental.
Yep. And also managed by former Chelsea boss Antonio Conte. This is his first trip.
These next 3 games with against Spurs is just I don't know about you. Even if we win 2 and lose 1, I probably feel the loss more than the 2 wins.
And it's obviously it's Conte's first visit back at the Bridge since he left us, or since he got sacked. More in a way. So. Spurs have been decent since Conte's came in, but when I look at that Spurs team and the way they've played, they're not really playing like an Antonio Conte side. They're not creating many chances whatsoever. They're creating some decent chances, you know, when you've got some of the attacking players you do. But he doesn't have the wing backs to play his system. He doesn't have the centre backs to be solid. The midfield's meh. And their attack's decent. Their attack will cause us problems, but Harry Kane has been very much off more than on this season. You know, going into this game against Spurs, we've got the better squad. We've got the momentum on our side because we have been playing quite well. We just aren't finishing our chances, which is leading us to not win games. It's a game which you just feel like, you know, you go into this and I'm actually quite confident. I'm never confident in cup games or against, but it's just about it. I feel like we're going to give a clear Conte a week less.
I'm confident because it's Spurs. Always confident when we play Spurs. Obviously, like the fear of losing is quite high with Spurs because it does affect me and a lot of other Chelsea fans, I'm sure. But I feel confident. I think after the Liverpool game, especially, I feel very confident after the Liverpool game. I know we drew, but I think a lot of people that can agree with the fact that we were by far the better side for 90 minutes at least. I feel confident. We'll win. I'm sure.
The thing is, I go into this and I think we all know what Antonio Conte is going to do. Antonio Conte is just going to sit back. He's going to play on the counter attack. There's going to be a lot of long balls to Harry Kane and to Son and. I fancy or whoever our back three is, so we'll go through our predicted lineups in a minute, but whoever our back three is, I 100% expect them to deal with it. I think Chelsea are going to be controlling the game. Spurs don't control games. We have the better midfield, no matter what midfielders we put out. It's just a matter of can we finish our chances, because it's been the backbone of Chelsea for this is not just this season. Frank Lampard had the same issue last year when players were not taking the chances. The season before, we had the same issue when we had Abraham and Drew, and then before Higuain, Jesus, dark time and Morata. You know, we just haven't had a goal scoring, and that's what Lukaku has started showing, and we start thinking Lukaku might be some form and happened and went down, and it's just a Chelsea thing. So anyway, let's go. I want to hear your predicted lineup. So obviously Kepa has to play in goal since Mendy's away today. Unless you're really playing Martinez Bettinelli for the shits and giggles.
I don't know. Okay, my predicted lineup. The thing is though, with these lineups though, it's also slightly what I want to happen. So I think Chalobah has been great. But lately, he's lost some confidence lately. So, do you play Silva? We can't play Christensen because he's injured, right?
Christensen and Chalobah are out.
Oh, Chalobah is out. Okay, that sorts out my problem anyway. I think it will be Azpilicueta right centre back, Silva central centre back, Rudiger left centre back. I think it'll be Pulisic right wing back, and Alonso left wing back. I want it to be a midfield again of Kante and Kovacic. That's what I want. And I think it'll be a front three of Cho left wing, Havertz up top, and Mount right wing. Personally, I don't see how we can set up differently. I don't know if you agree.
I've obviously Kevin does play. My back three is slightly different. I'm not playing Silva because Silva's played a ton of football recently, and I want him to be kind of. No, I think it's that you have to keep in mind that we do play Chesterfield, who are a non-league team at Stamford Bridge in the cup, so we should have to put much out against them to win. But yeah. I want to play Silva back to back. It worries me. We just say also fantastic news that he signed for another year. Incredible news. I generally love that man. He's incredible defenders, happy Sten, but I swap Silver out for Malanga Sarr. I like Sarr. What do you mean? Yeah, Sarr. Sorry, play central defense.
Really?
I just wouldn't play Silva. I think he will realistically play, yes. Fair enough. But I would not personally play him. I would play Malanga Sarr. So my back three would be Azpilicueta, Malanga Sarr, and Antonio Rudiger. I would not play Silva. I said the only reason Sarr plays is because the other guys are out. I don't like play. Then very similar difference as I put Jorginho in for Kante, because Kante has been incredibly injury prone these last 2.5 years. Ever since that Europa League final, when he got an injection on his knee to get through the game for his knee, it's completely screwed him ever since. He can't stay fit. Similar reasons. We may not need him against Chesterfield, but the longer the break he gets, the more his body may come together. Front three though, I do agree. I don't want to play Ziyech personally. I don't really.
It's not that I don't like Ziyech. Why have I got such a stuck throat right now? But I think the other three are performing is the difference. And we need Havertz in that centre-forward role compared to if we didn't play him. And then I think Mount and Hudson-Odoi play are much better in form. So I can see him playing Ziyech, but then I can also see him playing Ziyech against Chesterfield. So
I think Ziyech will play against Chesterfield, yes. I categorically do think that will happen. I think this is a big game for Hudson-Odoi, because to be fair, Chelsea fans have said, Sarri and Lampard didn't give Hudson-Odoi enough game time. And, Tuchel, to be fair, even though sometimes it's been out of position at the wing-back, I think he's been given a fair few chances, and there's sometimes he has done really, really well, like against Aston Villa. I think it was against Aston Villa, he had an incredible assist for Romelu Lukaku, fantastic ball across the top box. But then there's games like Brighton where he just doesn't take his bloody chances,
He did get slightly unfortunate with the clear handball in the box when he passed to Mount.
It was a clear handball.
It was a very, very clear handball.
Far didn't even look at that, by the way, because no Chelsea players are screaming for it. But also, the time like he went 1-1 on goal and he decided to square it.
I'm talking about when he squared it.
That wasn't a handball. It was a whole different such. It was a whole different thing.
No, that was definitely the handball one. When he was 1-1 with the keeper and squared it. I'll send you the clip again after. I'll send you the clip again after.
I'm pretty sure it's different.
After this podcast, mate.
All right. So Tom's trying to show me up on his fucking channel live. I got to edit that out.
It's my channel, mate.
What have you made of Christian Pulisic? Obviously, he's been playing in all sorts of positions. We've had him at false nine, we've had him in his winging position, and we've had him at right at wing back. Do you think he's not as good as we thought, or is it harsh to judge given he's playing?
I think it's quite harsh to judge him, because obviously he's moved around a lot more than anyone else, and he's also played a lot of minutes lately as well, like a lot of minutes. So I think it's harsh to judge him. And I think if you put all things into context, he's not done too badly. Because, again, when he plays right wing back, he hasn't really put a foot wrong. At left wing, he's looked a bit... At left wing and forward, he's looked a bit isolated, probably because he's been without a bounce board like he's had in the past. Lukaku's not been in last game and stuff like that. But then again, he scored against Liverpool, massive goal for us, because obviously he kept us, not necessarily in the title race, but certainly kept us going with the momentum. And we needed that goal in the end of the day. I think recently he's performed his best at right wing back, personally. So I think give him another chance there, because he seems to be doing all right.
That's fair enough. So the last thing is the most important one is obviously the big one, the score prediction. My prediction is a 1-0 Chelsea. 1-0 second half goal, Mason Mount.
I'm gonna go 2-1. I think we'll go ahead with Havertz. And then I think it'll be brought back by Son, and then Thiago Silva with a header later on in the game.
Oh, Thiago Silva with a header. Oh, Stamford Bridge singing, oh, Thiago Silva.
also, remember, we will be doing these Twitter predictions out on our Twitter at the Blue Podcast One, so do make sure you go put yours in the comments.
Yes, absolutely. And just also to add on to that, we will have other videos out this week too. If you haven't checked us in our Twitter, we have the Red, White, and Blue show returning as well. It's all returning this week on Saturday to NFL Grade Infinity, where me, Joe, and Connor all grade all 32 teams in the NFL and how we think that's done this year. It's gonna, that's when debates happen. And then also Tom's Blue Podcast with Ben will also be on the Friday. We said we are we're 13 subscribers off 900. So if anybody wants to please try and, you know, help us out, please do hit the subscribe button. You know, send this channel to anybody who likes any sort of football or American sport content, because we cover it all. And it's a big year. We've got so much content coming out. There's a match day vlog from my country, but there'll be a video on that about going into a bit more detail about that. So I'm not gonna go into too much detail about it. But Tom, anything you would like to add before we wrap it up?
No, I just think thank you very much for having me on, Josh. It was an absolute pleasure finally on the Royal Blue show, where I probably should be as a Chelsea fan. But do expect lots of things to come this year. We've really tried to hit the ground running with a lot of stuff behind the scenes that we're doing. So just enjoying the YouTube life right now, Josh.
And also just make sure you keep an eye on the YouTube, and I'll have a YouTube short out after the game, just giving a short reaction to how Chelsea do against the scum Tottenham Hotspur. Okay, no offense, Spurs fans, but I hate you all. So thank you all for watching, and enjoy the game if you decide to watch it. And the next video will be out on Friday with the Blue Podcast. So look forward to that, and thank you guys for watching.
Come on, mate.
Am I seeing signals up ahead, or am I imagining it all up in my mind? Looks like there's something there.